guys, slow down. Wow! The first 15 pages of the script, right? Have Marty skateboarding all over town, grabbing car bumpers. Don't do this, kids! Skip ahead to the mall parking lot. We see JCPenney's and a one-hour photo booth, right? We also see a stainless steel DeLorean. Sports car. But it's been modified.
Geez, Doc, it's a stainless steel DeLorean that's been modified. What the hell did you do?
Grab the camera and start taping, stink beast! I'll explain as we go. All right, this is test number one. Please note that Einstein's clock here is in precise synchronization with my control watch. A beat. If my calculations are correct, when this car hits 88 miles an hour, you're gonna see some serious shit!
Brown pushes the accelerator button on his remote control. The DeLorean takes off. The speedometer hits 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. I could keep going. Suddenly, it's engulfed by blinding white glow. And blam! It's gone. Just like my father's watch. A trail of fire, like a hemorrhoid, is left in its wake.
Christ almighty, Doc, you disintegrated Einstein!
Calm down, Marty Pig! I didn't disintegrate anything. The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact.
Then where the hell are they?
The appropriate question is, when the hell are they? Has just become the world's first time traveler. I sent him into the future, 1 minute into the
future,
to be exact. And at precisely 1:21 a.m. and 0 seconds, we shall catch up to him and the time machine.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you trying to tell me that you built a time machine out of a DeLorean?
If you're gonna build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out! Yes?
Suddenly, the DeLorean vanishes. Reappears. Then it vanishes again. Kind of like Peter Fonda on a bender. Brown approaches, reaches for the door handle, touches it, recoils in pain.
What is it? Hot.
It's cold! Damned cold!
You should work on your pauses. Brown raises the driver's door and compares his watch with Einstein's.
He's fine.
Oh, God.
And he's completely unaware that anything happened. As far as he's concerned, the trip was instantaneous. That's why his watch is 1 minute behind mine. He skipped over that minute to instantly arrive at this moment in time. Come here! I'll show you how it works. A beat.
A beat?
A beat.
A beat?
Here's a red letter date in the history of science. March 19, 1955.
Oh, well, that happened. Then.
That was good.
That was the day I invented time travel. I remember it vividly. I was standing on the edge of my toilet computer.